Hello and welcome, follow subscribers and other racing fans. Today we are gonna do another episode of Setup 101, and as you can see, we will tune up the BMW C4 for Nürburgring GP in Germany. One thing in front of all the others, Nürburgring is on a height above sea level of 600 and something meters, which is one of the highest tracks we have in Project Cars. On a similar level are only Bathurst with I think 800 meters and Willow Springs with also around 500 to 600 meters. I don't know if these figures are exactly, but they are in the ballpark. So, with the C4 we have a natural disadvantage to turbo-driven cars like the McLaren and the Bentley, which is not so optimal. And you can also see that in the lap times which we have. A 54.5 for the C4, and let's take the McLaren. There we have a 54.1. Okay, difference is not so big as I thought, but well, big enough to take the C4 and try to get the best out of it. Yeah, you can see a big difference to the Bentley, though. Okay. Well, then let's try our best. Start the session. I will reset the setup if there is one. I'm not actually sure, because I have never, or I can't remember having done a setup for the car, so let's just go right into the setup and reset it, but I guess we won't have any other numbers. 215 in the front, 207 in the rear. Speaking of tire pressure, yeah, the same. So, okay, think I will, I will reduce the fuel to half the tank, which is around 50 here in this car. And the rest I will actually let the rest on default values for now, except for the steering ratio. If you have seen my other videos, I like to have a slower steering ratio, especially for cars with much front grip, because it allows me to steer a little bit more precisely. And yeah, I do that for every car. How much front weight bias here on default? Okay, save it, and let's just take it for a ride and see what we can achieve here. Changing the camera with Control and K. I got this question a lot of times in the past weeks, so just tell it right away. Oh, I got automatic clutch activated. Should be deactivated now, and I want to activate TC, which is activated now. As you might know, this car already has some kind of stability control in real 8s. However, in some leagues, for example the Gentleman's League TGC, this stability control, as I'm adjusting my seat in the real world. Okay, now should be okay. Yeah, it is not allowed for example, in the gentleman's club, because rules and regulations from 2014 onwards didn't allow this aid anymore in real life. So I'm trying my best out the stability control. Okay. Car seems to have so much grip. Really like it. Also is very calm on track. It's a very safe car to drive. I think the default setup for this car is one of the best on all GT3 cars. Okay. Now, the problem here in this track is obviously the last chicane. You can cut quite an amount there. Not sure if I should do this in my videos, because showing what my setup can do and comparing it to leaderboard times, I guess that includes cutting this chicane, because people did this to achieve the times. So if I don't do it, you will say, ah, your setup, it doesn't help me. By the way, I don't make setups for you just to take them and drive them everywhere. That is not possible anyway. I'd rather have it like that. I do setups and I explain what I change in the setup, and you learn from it what changes do what on the car, and then you can make the changes yourself. That would be the most or the best thing to do with my videos. But I don't tell you what to do, okay? A little bit too late. The rear is a little bit unstable in off-throttle situations. However, I will reduce the engine brake mapping nonetheless. Because, oops, too late. In situations like this, I need more engine braking. Okay. That will probably be the next thing I will do. So we need more differential. I have it on several cars on this track, because you lose power due to the height as a natural aspirated car. So I need more acceleration diff, and this acceleration diff will give me a little bit more oversteering exiting the corner. What I'm missing with the less power. Okay. Yeah, I cut the track. It's already starting and doing it. Tire temps are okay. Also the rear. The rear, sorry, had to concentrate there. Rear could be a little bit higher. Too late on the throttle here. I will probably go with less downforce. I think I have so much grip. I have too much grip. So a little bit less downforce. It's not, this track is not a low downforce track. Whoops! Okay. Okay, I'm hanging here. So, let's return to the pits. Let's see. Front temperatures were okay, rears were a little bit low. Not too low, 85 degrees Celsius, it's quite okay, but lower them. Yeah, lower them a little bit, okay. Then brake pressure. Yeah, we are using ABS, so 90 is totally okay. I was also okay with the brake balance, so no problems there. Brake temperatures, they were high in turn 1 and a little bit low in the other turns, so I'm reducing them a little bit. Traction control, I will increase the number, forgot in the first round. As you also know, I'm always increasing it to 15% because I actually don't need the traction control under normal conditions, and I only use it for these situations where you hit curbs and the wheel would spin like crazy and cause you to spin when it's in the air and then it comes down on the ground again and then you spin, and I want that to not happening. Okay. Next thing, brake mapping. I said we'll reduce it to get more turn in on off throttle situations. I'm not off throttle anyway, so this is no problem at all. Yeah. Yeah, you should always be a little bit on the throttle to make a better exit of the corners. Final drive. I think we maybe can put it a little bit to acceleration, but it may be too much. So I'm not sure about this. We might have to revert the setting. Okay, I will increase this to 30 here. Good. Whiskers lock. not sure if that would help us. A change here would help us in any way, so I'm just leave it. Bump stops are quite okay. I think we can reduce the ride height, because except for the last chicane, if you cut it, you don't have problems with bottoming out car. strange. Cannot speak today. Okay, that was too much. There's a thing. Do we adjust? You know, if you lessen the right height more than the front, at the rear right height more than the front right height, you will get a little bit more grip on the rear. We only lose grip on the rear during this. I'm generally very okay with the balance of the car, so I'm leaving it here now. The spring rates could be a little bit stiffer. Maybe, maybe not. I will just leave them now, I think. Yeah. Rear sway bar is okay, front sway bar should be okay for now. We will reduce the camber a little bit, because we don't really use it on this track, so put it on 2 and 5, 1.9. We'll reduce it more in the front, because we want to achieve a little bit more stable rear in the last chicane. Maybe a little bit more toe in angle on the rear too, because if you increase that angle, you get more straight line stability, and this is what we need in this corner. Okay, the downforce, I will, it's 1.9, so I will reduce it to 1 and 4 or 5, 5. Okay, see what this brings us. Okay, the white beer is quite okay. Maybe it could go a little bit more to the rear. Good. We have a pretty balanced car, as I said before, and there is some room for making it less oversteery, as this was the only problem in our first round. So I'm setting the car a little bit more to understeer. Good. Good, 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 good. Okay. It should be okay for now. Let's give it another test. And not that you say I am doing setup changes which are contrary, because I did increase the acceleration diff. But said I will make it a more understeery car. Well, that is because exiting the corners it should oversteer more, and entering the corners it could be a little bit more understeering. Getting get not much more speed out of the lower downforce setup, so maybe at a later point I will rebuild that. Let's just see if the gears are long enough now. Seem to be okay. A bit too much understeering there. So braking was a little bit late. Oh, I think first gear is not okay anymore. Oh, I forgot to activate the telemetry screen for you. I got the best time in first sector, although it was awful. Interesting. It was awful too. Nah. Too late on the throttle actually. This car allows so much more, so much earlier throttle aggression out of the corner. Yes, cut the track. Come on. I think I will reduce rear downforce by one click. Okay, that was better, I think. Not optimal, it's important to get this right, this right-hander. Also here, early on the throttle, to get all the momentum down the hill. Also here, early on the throttle, and I was too late. Come on! Full throttle here, important. Okay, it was not good. Ah, awful lap. Now we have the problem. The two hot brakes in turn 1. As you could see, I had to countersteer a little bit out of the corner. But it was still quite fast. And there you had it. Wheel spin on the curb. What saved me? Traction control. Oh. That was not good. Okay, 56.1 without cutting too much of the chicane, but brakes are too hot now, so brake ducts back to 75. Also, I'm reducing tire pressures all around according my temperatures, which are 90 to 100 in the front, which is quite okay, but it's peak temperatures, so can be a little bit less tire pressure. And in the rear, 80, and in the rear right, 75, so tire pressure should be okay now. We'll also increase the brake pressure, as I think there's not the full potential of the brakes happening here. Whew. Now I'm trying to run a little bit faster lap, so I'm reducing the fuel accordingly. The final drive is quite okay, as you could see. It was nice. It's also okay, everything okay. Although the radiator, you might want to increase a little bit for a race. I got temperatures of around 105 degrees Celsius, and up to 110 is okay, but it's quite high already. If you have a little bit of a demolished chassis, you might want to have more radiator opening. So in the race, I would say 60 to 70%. Bumps, I will reduce the bump stops, because we don't have bumps on this track, and it helps if you reduce it. It helps to to make the car a little bit softer without changing the springs. Yeah. Also, I will give it the rear fast bumps. Here they are. We'll reduce them by 2 clicks. So in the last chicane, a little bit more rear stability. And contrary again, I will decrease rear downforce by 1. I'm pretty sure for a fast qualifying lap you can run with 0-0. No problem. Actually, we are trying 0-3. Let's see how this turns out. Good. Now test it again. I will also do now, I will give it one more rear braking balance, because it understeers a little bit under heavy braking. Quite good. We have a little bit more understeering here now, maybe because of the bump stops and the fast bumps. However, we still get the corner, the Schumacher S, I mean, the SS. In the race with with less grip on the tires because of worn tires, that might get a problem. Can't say for sure. However, it's always a thing if you are 1 second faster per lap before, you can also you can also lose half a second per lap in the later phase of the race because you made it up at first. Some setup changes are compromises. Have to compromise quite much on some tracks. Getting better here, getting worse there. Just have to see what suits you better. Maybe a little bit too early on throttle. Okay, was off track during braking there, which didn't help at all to make the corner. I think the car feels great now. And you can also see that my lap times increased quite much. I think I could go even more extreme on some settings to achieve a faster time. However, we don't want this in the setup 101. We want a setup which is on the limit for racing, but still able to win races. If you go, if you go full on qualifying time, might not be able to win a race because the car is too hard to drive then. and I want to give you a setup which is okay for 1 hour of racing. Yeah, I know where I lost the time in this Dunlop Kehre corner. Yeah, we have to avoid the curbs here on this track. Okay, my potential best is now a 55.5. Brakes got a little bit worse due to overheating. So my last changes will include the brake balance. Too early on throttle again. The brake balance and the brake duct. Yeah, you can brake much later in here, which I did now. Last corner was a little bit messy. However, 55.5s are possible with this setup. And if you want more, I recommend you to lower the tire pressures even more and to lower the downforce to 0.0. That will definitely help. And for the sake of a good race for you all, I'm doing some changes for the race now, which is a one click to the rear on the brake balance. This is a very individual setting, yes. I recommend you to put it as far to the front as possible. However, be careful not to get too much understeering, okay? So, yeah. Fuel loads. Ah, yeah. I also got too much fuel load for a faster lap. So, remember to get 15 liters or so fuel. Should be totally okay. Radiator. I'm opening for the race to 60. Okay, the rest should be okay so far. Also for the qualifying, I recommend you a little bit stiffer sway bars. Maybe 1-2 clicks stiffer sway bars. What do we have for click? Oh, okay. It's 2 Newton per millimeter clicks, so you can put in two or three clicks of it for a faster qualifying lap. Okay, well, for now, I think we have been quite fast this time. For now, everything is okay. I have 55.5 with the C4. Not the fastest possible according to the leaderboard, but okay, you have the setup. You can ask me question about the setup. I will put it on Project Cars setups.eu, which is the setup site fan made for the setups. And well, if you have questions, just ask me. Else I don't have to say anything. Yeah, so I'm closing this now. See you next time for the next setup 101, and bye bye.